it's what I'm going through and what I've been going through, and I think a lot of people are going through that.
Yeah,
pretty sure if you have a smartphone, if you're on the internet, if you own a laptop or what, you're going through the same thing. So look, I'm an artist, I'm a visual artist. So what I've seen is that most of the work that I do, I post it online, right? And that's how I get my artwork bought. That's how I get it bought. That's just how I run my business. So this is what I discovered. I just saw that recently, not recently, because I've been you'll get to understand why I'm saying this. Look at this. I was just looking at myself and on how I behave and how I do some of the things. So I noticed that when I do my artwork, right, inside me there's this thing that is just looking for a reward. I don't know if I'm making sense. Like there's this thing that is, I think it's something behavior, like it's my behavior or it's behavior or something. But I noticed that when I produce a piece of art, there's this thing within me that is just looking for feedback, right? And I used to find it so weird, and then I decided to just dive deep and just do some research on myself and other different sources. So I discovered that if I do some artwork and post it online, there's this thing inside me that is just looking for reward, feedback from people, and what people are going to say based on the particular work that I produced. And I just felt at a point that I feel like now I'm doing work for feedback. I'm doing the artwork that I produce. I'm seeking a lot of feedback from people. I'm just looking for comments, if people like it or if people don't. And I just discovered that it messes up with my creativity, because now I ended up, like, I used to rush artworks. Like if I'm drawing something that is taking so much time, I used to feel this drag inside me that I have to finish it as soon as possible, so that I post it and I get the feedback from people, which was a negative thing for my artwork. It was my negative thing because I ended up rushing work and just doing a lot of crazy stuff just for that reward that I get from social media, that reward I get from people giving me feedback on my work, if they like it or not, right? So I just then decided to, okay, look, I just have to dive deep and do some research based on what I was feeling. Then I discovered that, okay, look, this has to do with a lot of dopamine fixes. I discovered that that reward mechanism that works inside us, it's the same. It's something that we have inside us, that we are social, we are just social creatures. So we just need feedback from people and all that. And all this dopamine is addictive. It's like when you post something online, you just expect more likes than before, which is directly proportional to the amount of dopamine that is released into your brain, right? It's and then the frightening thing is that when I did a lot of research on this topic, I found out that the reward mechanism that your body gets is the same reward mechanism that people who smoke drugs, people who do cocaine and everything get. So we are just a society that is just so drowned in dopamine, and we're so dependent on it. We're so dependent. And less people are talking about it. It has become a norm now. And then I just then discovered that, okay, I have to just dive deep and read about this topic more and get to know this topic more. And then I find out that there's a lot of people that's been studying this type of concept way before social media, way before we get to post things online and all that. There's a scientist called, I think it's B.F. Skinner, who did a lot of behavioral experiments using different animals. He did an experiment using a rat or what? A rat whereby he enclosed the rat, a rat, and then he had like two different tubes. Like it's, I won't be accurate, but it's something like two different tubes, with one which had cocaine inside it, a drug inside it mixed with water. The other one had just plain water, right? So it was something that the rat, even though that cocaine was so detrimental to the rat kept on coming back to tap on that particular container which had that cocaine in it, which had that particular substance in it that is so addictive and that's so dopamine releasing, up until the rat died, because now it didn't drink the water which was clean and all that and healthy for it, but it was just indulging on the negative substance just for the dopamine fixes. And then I was like, oh, so cool, there's something in this. I have to do some research and dive deep into it even more, right? And then I started reading a lot of different articles and studies and books based on the concept. I decided to just stop posting work every time after doing it, and posting it once a month. So I post my work once a month, so I can finish work and then just store it aside. Then after a month, I post everything that I did, right? I just discovered a lot of changes in myself. Now I started giving a lot of attention to my work and taking as much time in doing my work, which even gave me more time to reflect on myself, on how I see my work and not how other people see my work, right? And then, which was, okay, it was hard at first not logging in online on Facebook, on YouTube, on Snapchat, on all that, those social platforms. But then after a while, I started adjusting, and I feel like now I love my life even more that I'm not on those platforms as often as I was before. Studies are beginning to show links between smartphone usage and increased level of anxiety and depression, poor sleep quality, and increased risk of car injury or death. Many of us wish we spend less time on our phones, but find it incredibly difficult to disconnect. Why are our smartphones hard to ignore? This is from the article that I read. And it just poses the same questions that I used to have about it. Why are our phones are so hard to ignore? And to my surprise, right, these smartphone companies have people who are hired to study how people behave when they're on the platform, how to delay likes. There's this thing that I saw, which they delay, the algorithm delay showing you the likes that you have, but it gives you the likes in large quantities so that you see them in just large quantities. And I find that so weird that these smartphone companies employ people to study such a thing. Cognitive neuroscientists have shown that rewarding social stimuli, laughing faces, positive recognition by our peers, message from loved ones activate the same dopamine energy reward pathways. Smartphones have provided us with a visually unlimited supply of social stimuli, both positive and negative. Every notification, whether it's a text message, a like on Instagram, or a Facebook notification, has the potential to be a positive social stimulus and dopamine influx. That's pretty much what was happening with me before, and that's what is happening with a lot of people. Some of the people like it. I didn't like it. I don't know if you like it or not. Just that now, I don't think it's normal. Like way back, people used to get posts sent to us, and then we look at them once a day. Now you have this social interaction that is not ending. Every minute, every hour, every time, there's something coming in. There's input, and I don't think that's healthy. And that's just time consuming. I don't think that's how we evolved to be, right? So I feel like we need to start monitoring how we use these platforms. They are beautiful platforms, but we need to start monitoring how we use them, and yeah, just how we use them and how they are detrimental to our health and to our well-being. This is just my view, and this is just something that I felt like I should share with you guys.